Find the perfect mix of rhythm and blues and jazz, add a little down-home feel, and you've discovered the unique sound of John Lee Hooker Jr. He's the son of the legendary blues musician John Lee Hooker. John Lee Jr. is a two-time Grammy nominee and has shared the red carpet with the world's best musicians, and he's played alongside the likes of B.B. King, Lenny Kravitz, and Bo Diddley. John Lee Jr. started playing at a young age. Even then, people predicted that he would become another Hooker legend, just like his father.
My dad came out with a hit, Boom Boom Boom, and my peers, moms and dads, knew what a hit record was and explained it. Wow, your dad got a hit record, and that's what was playing.
But John Lee Jr. had a secret. He was addicted to drugs. He started using marijuana in middle school, and the drugs got progressively stronger. In his early years in high school, he started shooting heroin.
I woke up thinking about drugs. I went to sleep thinking about drugs. At lunch periods in school, after school was over, I thought about drugs. Drugs was the thing.
John was constantly in and out of county jail on drug-related crimes. During one stay, his cellmate wanted to teach John how to defend himself if he ever had to go to the penitentiary. So they started boxing.
He would stand right in the cell door and say, "Now get out of here if you can." And I'd box my way out, and after I'd box my way out, he'd say, "Good work. I'm just getting you ready."
And just as his cellmate predicted, when John Lee Jr. turned 18, he was moved to adult prison.
You're a kid, and you got guys in there 30 and 40, and who is this little young boy that's coming in here? And you're like, oh my God, what have I gotten myself into?
John quickly learned about the dark side of prison life after his friend was raped by a cellmate.
And of course, as a youngster, you say to yourself, dang, that could happen to me as well. You know, and just...
The day that same inmate tried to rape John Lee Jr., John had to rely on every boxing lesson his former cellmate had ever taught him.
I grabbed him and threw him up against the bars and threw him and punched him, and I beat him up.
You're not gonna get me like you got my friend!
When John Lee got out of prison, he went right back to using drugs, and his music career ended. He was homeless, living on the streets, and overdosed so many times he lost count.
I have had uncles, parents tell me, "You're gonna die from drugs." We already know. You will die from drugs. I believed them. I believed them, and I said, "I know," but I didn't care.
By the time John Lee Jr. reached his 40s, he was shooting heroin into his neck because the veins in his arms had collapsed. He developed a severe infection, and when he went to the hospital, he faced up to the possibility he could die.
The doctor looked at my neck and said, "We need to get that infection out or you'll die." Instantly, I broke out crying, and he says, "You could die any minute.
Hang in there, okay?"
And laying on my hospital bed, I just basically said, "Lord Jesus, I need you to walk me through with this ordeal." I said, "Please help me, have mercy on me. Help me. Can he help me? He helped me."
At that moment, John Lee prayed to become a Christian. But when he recovered from the surgery, he still faced more drug-related charges. His mother came to the sentencing to pray for her son.
And as I was standing there and they were reading off the charges, I knew just like I know that this handkerchief is white, they are going to send me to prison. And I saw my mom out in the audience with her head bowed, and she was praying. And the judge said, "You're worth salvaging. I'm not going to send you to jail." And in my heart, I know that the Lord Jesus Christ heard my mama's prayers in my behalf.
The judge sent John Lee to a drug rehab program, which he successfully completed. He relaunched his music career with 3 new albums, received 2 Grammy nominations, and walked the red carpet drug-free. And everyone who knows him will tell you that something remarkable has happened in his life.
Jesus is my good friend. He's a star that shines in the darkness when I don't know which way to go. When I'm lonely, I can speak with him. He's my hope and he's my joy. And he has caused my name that people didn't trust. Now I have a good name, and not because of celebrity, but because of what he has done for me.